So now espresso. Espresso is really important, and espresso takes testing. The best way for you or for me to roast espresso is for me to find what I'm looking for in the notes and the flavor, which currently I really like is our tri blend again. Currently I'm using a Brazilian with Peruvian and Colombian. Now I'm using less of the Peruvian because I don't want it light. I want it more dark and more bright because it's a fast process. That curvature of flavor is very quick. And so what I want to do is I want that 30-second pull on my espresso machine. I want that single shot to be at that 18 to 19 grams of ground coffee, really fine, but not so fine that the water doesn't pull through too fast enough, but not so loose or so coarse that the water comes through really fast. You'll notice a difference when you do decaf, water comes through really fast, and that's because of the process of the decaf, the water process of decaf. But when it comes to your espresso, you want a fine grind, you want a 30-second pull, you want that ounce and a half, 2 ounces and 3/4, 2 ounces at most of water through that 19 grams. And then if you're doing a second, if you're doing a double shot, you can just pull two shots, or you can actually combine those, get a 45 second, go to 3 ounces of water and get about 28 to 30 grams of ground coffee if you have a portafilter large enough to do that. Most people don't, and that's okay. Pull two separate shots. You'll get a little more water and a little more espresso. You're losing a little bit of your cost ratio in that, but it still makes for a fantastic cup of coffee. Now, the reason why I'm using, again, those Central South American coffees is because of the chocolate cocoa flavoring. And so that chocolate cocoa flavoring, that flavor, not really flavorings, the notes of chocolate and cocoa help with espresso. It keeps that curvature a little shorter. It's durable, which means I can pull the fast shots with it and I don't lose the flavor. That's the thing about those coffees with our espresso. So it's really, really good when it has that. So again, these coffees are 1/3, your espresso currently is 1/3 Peruvian, 1/3 Brazilian, 1/3 Colombian. And that flavor profile works really, really, really good with espresso machines. The Simonelli it works really good with, as well as my new one. I've got an espresso mat, and so mine's a Italian made, Spanish put together. And so most of my parts are Italian, but Spanish put together. Why is that important? I say all that because you have a lot of control with your Simonelli and with my type of machine. You have a lot of control on the water to coffee ratio. You need to be testing that regularly, at least once a week, where you make sure it's pulling the same amount of shot water, the same amount of process. And you can do that by testing the water level without any espresso, testing the water level with espresso, and testing your grind regularly. If you need some teaching on that, it may be something you guys, next time I'm down delivering coffee or somebody comes up here to pick up, I can work on that with you, all right? Again, you're still gonna get the same flavors as a little bit more on the darker side. You're gonna get a little bit more of the toasted almond, a little bit more of the yellow fruit and the flavor, but you're gonna get a good bit of that dark chocolate. So like the cooking chocolate, dark chocolate flavor. So it's not as sweet, but it has a really full body. And that's the reason why I use that for our espresso.